Everybody, welcome back to the Iron Oak Sawmill. On the mill today, big black walnut log, 32 inch on the big end, 30 inch on the small end, about 9.5 feet long. Gonna get a lot of nice clear lumber out of this. Customer wants to cut at 8/4, so, and random width is fine. So we're just gonna cut for best yield. And yes, some of the boards will include some sapwood in it, but beyond that, it's gonna have some really nice clear black walnut lumber. So let's get started. All right, let's see if we can get milled up with this one. There's very little sapwood on this, maybe 2 inches, if that, inch and a half. And you got the bark on there as well. But all the measurements I gave you were inside the bark, so not much sapwood on this one at all. It's pretty nice. And here you go, folks. As usual, it's looking a bit on the green side when you first cut black walnut open. But as it starts to get exposed to the air, it's going to turn a nice, deep, rich brown. Deep, dark brown. Man, it's clear as a bell in here. And we are using a bimetal blade. I ordered two of these a while back. I was not happy with the first one. It jumped off the mill and ruined it, essentially. It took some teeth out on it, so it was no good after only a few cuts. Not sure what happened. This one so far, we cut pine with it yesterday, or Norway spruce. It cut really well. And it's still continuing to cut really well today. You saw us looking for rocks and stuff stuck in the bark, which we have a problem of since we are in the driveway today, and this log has been rolled across this driveway a couple of times. So, really nice. Really nice. That cut is really good. If you want it rustic looking wood with a rough sawn finish, this ain't it. This is really smooth. Let's get back to cutting.
Okay, as I turn this log to get the third face opened up, see Deb in the background there, greeting one of our customers, return customer, coming back to pick up some four-quarter red oak. Can't quite get the outer blade guide roller to pass over the log, so got to remove a little bit of the bark here with the old hatchet. Let's get it cleaned up and get this next cut in. Time to go lend the sales and marketing department a hand and see if we can find this customer what they need. What we're doing here is trimming off just the corner of this log. Just a small amount so we can clear the outer blade guide roller.
Wow, look at this. Beautifully clear black walnut. And of course a little wind here at the sawmill. It's always windy here at the sawmill. Man. Yeah, this log's big enough we have to do a little special trimming off the edges to get down through it, but no live edges off of this. The customer only wants 2-inch lumber. And that will do. So, man, beautiful stuff. And you'll see this start to just turn a rich, rich brown color. So we'll give you a shot of that once we're done milling. Take a look at it and show you what I mean.
Okay, because of the sheer size and weight of this log, we're trying to get it to turn and set down easy on the deck of the mill. It's not good to let these logs slam into the deck as much as we do here, so we're trying to change that a little bit. Let's see if we're successful on this one.
Still really nice clear black walnut. And I got one concern right here. Got a little discoloration. Concern there might be some metal down in there, so we're gonna go get our new metal detector because our old wand type that we had, Lumber Wizard, did not go deep enough into the wood to tell me where any metal was. So if I see signs of metal, I get the metal detector out and check it. Most of the time I catch them before they become an issue. But this stuff is looking great. clear stuff yet. 16 3/4 inches wide. 8 1/4 black walnut. Nothing better. Well, except for maybe that box elder. That box elder is awesome. I still like that stuff. Starting to pick up a little bit of that branch stub that was on the side. We're not looking for curl figure on this or any kind of exciting figure. Just looking for nice grain black walnut. It's going to be a lot of it in this log. Let's keep going, folks. Customers. Seems like this is their best part of advertising.
Yeah, going out front.
You know, in the driveway, lots of people stop by. Not that anybody can hear me on the camera. Right? Let's cut the other side off. I'm going to cut the other side off. Go all the way through because I'm picking up a knot on this side. On this side, and probably gonna pick one up here. Thank you. All right, guys, check this out. Still on the greenish side, but 100% clear, one end to the other. This is the best side of the log we have. We're gonna go right straight through the cant from this side and end up with the most clear lumber we're gonna get out of this. He wanted the clearest, widest boards he could get. And some of this will actually turn into quarter sawn as we get closer to the pith. Although the pith will have to be cut out of each piece, but once you get down there, so. Beautiful. Good side-by-side comparison here. You can see the one on the right just came, the one on the left just came off of the mill. Let's get them both out into the sunlight here. One on the left just came off the mill. One on the right, as you can see, starting to turn a nice brown color. And when you hit this again with some water, you really get to see it. But by tomorrow, that'll be a nice deep rich brown. Beautiful stuff. Second cut of going through the final cant. Mark. All right, guys. More beautiful stuff. A little bit of figure popping up here. I think we're about ready to find an old branch that was in there. Man, nice stuff. Like I said, this is the clearest side we have. We're just gonna cut straight down through from here. We'll probably pick up branches. We're just about to the pith of the log right here. So I'll probably take the next one right about here. And that'll put the pith right about in the center of the next board, which would be fine. That could be cut out of that board. And you'll have two small ones off each side, quarter sawn, black oak. You saw in the beginning, I leveled the pith, which means it's the same height or the same distance on this end right here and off the bottom as on the other end. So when you do cut to keep the pith in that one board, it will be in that one board the same distance all the way down. So, all right, let's get into our next cut. to walk back. Okay?
Okay.
Pull back.
This is nice. Okay?
Okay, before we get to edging things out, I stopped getting pictures on the mill, but even with these knots in it, the figure's awesome in these things. So you want some rustic pieces, you want to get this re-sewn. Not exactly sure what he's planning on using it for, but man, see how green that is, and the sides already turning brown. Green, brown. Sides over here are all turning brown, so nice stuff. Let's get back to edging. Thank you. one, that'll wrap it up here once again on the Iron Oak Sawmill. I don't know the board footage exactly. I will have to calculate it though for the customer, but a lot of beautiful 8-quarter walnut, upwards of 16 inches wide. Man, this stuff is awesome. Customer also has some nice spruce boards over here. We did another bunch of 8-quarter spruce boards yesterday. Unfortunately, camera malfunctions. I've got very little footage of that. So we have what we have for that one. Maybe I'll get something together for that. We'll see. But hey, guys, we are close to 10,000 subscribers. We're going to be doing another free giveaway. We're not sure what it is yet, but when we do the video, we'll show you what it is. You have to subscribe and comment in that video. It's upcoming. We've got about 110 to go yet. Should have that in about a week or so. No, we're not getting them like crazy like some guys are, but take about a week, I think, to get those next 110. So if you're a subscriber and you comment on that video, you'll be sure to win that free prize. We did one before at 5,000 subscribers, now 10,000, and we're looking forward to that. So I'd like to thank everybody for their support for the channel. If you've got any questions about what we're doing here on the mill, or any of the equipment we're using, or any questions about the sawmill, anything, put it down in the comments section. Be glad to help you out. I'd like to thank everybody for coming out. We'll see you out here next time.
I want to thank everybody for subscribing to our channel. Hopefully you enjoy the black walnut log. It is actually beautiful, if you ask me. Beautiful green in it. And I think the customer will be very, very happy with it. Keep on watching, subscribe to our channel, and have a good day. And we are enjoying the weather. Thank you very much, everybody, and take care. I'm done. What did you do?
I'm working back.
No, you did some.
See, she does talk.